Hi, welcome back to our DIY Autonomous Mobile Robot Building Series. Here in part two, we're diving into the nitty-gritty of designing our circuit using Fritzing. If you're new to this, don't worry, we're going to walk through it step by step. If you haven't checked out part one yet, either access the link in the video description or select the link at the end of this video. First things first, open up your Fritzing software. If you haven't installed it yet, you can download it from fritzing.org. Fritzing used to be free, but nowadays they require a one-time payment of 8 euros, which is about 9 US dollars. So let's first start by selecting New Sketch and then selecting the Breadboard tab. In this robot project, we will not be installing a breadboard in our robot, but rather a perfboard, the exact same one as I showed you in part 1 of this series. We want our circuit to have a good design, so we'll start with the breadboard and convert it to a PCB later on in the design process, and then base our design on the PCB to design our circuit for the actual perfboard. Alright, let's start with the power source. Search for battery in the search window here. Let's drag the two AA batteries in a battery holder from the parts bin onto the workspace. Place it next to the breadboard. Change the voltage to 4.8 volts and then four batteries appear. However, for some reason the batteries automatically change to AAA batteries, but that's not so important, we can ignore that. Actually, I prefer to have the positive rail on the top side of the breadboard, so I'll just rotate the breadboard around. Now connect the positive terminal to the positive rail on the breadboard and the negative terminal to the ground rail. Now let's bring in the Arduino, place it above the breadboard. We'll connect the Arduino up in a moment. Next we will add the microservo SG90. However, Fritzing doesn't have this component on its parts menu. I decided to download a free version of this component from GitHub. I just searched Fritzing download SG90 on Google and found this link from GitHub, and I was able to download the file TowerPro SG90 servo.fzpz on that site. After downloading that file, you just open the file and Fritzing inserts the component into the core parts bin. Okay, so now let's bring in the micro servo and place it above the battery holder. Connect the power wire to the positive rail by selecting the end of the red wire and dragging it to the positive rail on the breadboard. The initial color of the wire is either blue or the color of the wire that you used previously. Color the wire red by selecting red here. Drag the ground wire to the ground rail and this time color it black. The color of the ground wire is either black or brown on the servo. Next, we need to connect the signal wire, which is orange on the servo, to PWM pin number 11 on the Arduino. I prefer to colour the signal wires yellow for the servos, but it is entirely up to you which colour to use. It is always best practice to keep red and black positive and negative though. Speaking of which, I might just bring the positive and negative wires from the battery a little closer. If you press shift while moving the corners, you can get a clean right angle bend. Search for HCSR04 in the parts menu. Select and drop it onto the breadboard. In our actual build, we will not be directly connecting the ultrasonic sensor onto the perfboard, but via connectors and wires. Our ultrasonic sensor is going to be rotatable via the microservo SG90. So actually, this connection on the breadboard is going to be converted into just a row of four header pins. Connect the VCC pin to the positive rail. Select the pinhole here. Drag a wire to a pinhole around here and color it red. Then you need to run another red wire from here to the positive rail. For those who are not familiar with breadboards, I should mention that these connection holes along the top two rows, and also the bottom two rows, are only horizontally connected to each other, whereas these sets of five holes in the upper middle section are connected to each other vertically only, and are not connected to either the upper or lower rows, nor are they connected to the columns of the lower middle section. The lower middle section has the same connection relationship as that of the upper middle section. Carrying on, we connect the ground pin to the ground rail by running a horizontal wire on the right side here, colouring it black, and then a vertical wire up to the ground rail. I might as well connect the ground wire to the Arduino ground while I'm at it. Next, connect the trig pin to the digital pin number 4 on the Arduino by running a horizontal wire to the right, colouring it green, and then connect another wire vertically, and then another green wire to digital pin number 4. You can easily add bending points on the wires by selecting and pulling it. In the same manner, connect the echo pin to digital pin number 7, colouring it blue instead. Please note that trig is always a digital pin, whereas echo can be a PWM or any digital pin. Also, it is a good idea to label your components, so let's do that now before we go on any further. Next up, let's add the left and right modified servos. As I mentioned in part 1, we are using high-tech HS311 servos that have been modified to continuously rotate. By the way, if you want to know how to modify these servos to continuously rotate, look out for the link at the end of this video. I couldn't find any such servos either in Fritzing or on the net, so we'll just use the generic servos in Fritzing. So search servo in the parts bin, and you will find a generic servo motor. Place two of these servos to the right side of the breadboard, and we will label the top one left servo and the bottom one right servo. Connect the signal wire from the left servo to PWM pin number 10 on the Arduino, and connect the signal wire from the right servo to PWM pin number 9 on the Arduino. Then connect each power wire to the positive rail and each ground wire to the ground rail. Now that is everything connected up, so now we can move on to the actual circuit design stage. Click on the schematic tab here and you will find an incomplete schematic diagram of our circuit in disarray. We are not going to bother about the schematic diagram and move straight to the PCB tab. Now in the PCB tab, it is possible to design an actual printed circuit board and you can get your circuit manufactured. This might only cost about $5 and you'll probably end up spending more on postage. It also may take a few weeks to arrive. In any case, we will not get our circuit manufactured for this project as it doesn't seem worth it. We will only need to solder a small number of wires for our design. However, this design tool for PCBs will be quite useful for designing our circuit, as you will soon see. We will use this PCB footprint that is simply labelled PCB1, but we will pretend that it is our perfboard, so let's label it accordingly. We should also resize it to that of our perfboard, 72mm by 47. This is the Arduino board footprint, so let's move it under the perfboard. This is because when we do assemble the components into the robot, I do want to have the perfboard located above the Arduino. This is actually the 4.8 volt battery holder or battery pack, but it is unnecessarily large for our circuit design as we only need to show a positive pin and a ground pin to which the battery holder will connect. So what we will do is go back to the breadboard tab, select the battery holder and change it back to 3 volts, even though we will be using 4 1.2 volt rechargeable batteries. Now let's go back to the PCB tab and we can see that the large box-like object has disappeared, and we have a small 2-pin connector-sized rectangle in its place. So let's move the VCC, or the battery pins, and the ultrasonic sensor. This sensor needs to be rotated, I think, so you can easily do that by selecting it and pressing rotate here. Here is the micro servo SG90. Let's move that onto the perf board. Here will do. The right servo, and then the left servo 2. Which are the HS311 servos that have been modified to rotate continuously. Now with all the components on the perf board, we can zoom in a bit. Actually, when I say components, I mean the connector pins for the components. I'll just move the label for the ultrasonic sensor, zoom in a bit more. I'll move the VCC over here. The various dotted lines are not actually connections, but suggestions. When you move a component, sometimes those lines change to different connection points. Now we want to move the SG90, or actually the header pin for the micro servo, up here a bit because we don't want the wires from the header pins interfering with the wires that extend from the header pins for the ultrasonic sensor. Actually, I should put the ultrasonic sensor in the center here. I think it would be probably best to rotate the left and right servos, or the header pins to which the left and right servos connect. Just select the component and press rotate. Let's rotate and move the labels too. If we are going to get the PCB manufactured, these labels would be printed on the PCB. I'll just align the right servo with the VCC and align the leftmost pin with ground. I'll just move the left servo too. Now let's connect some of the wires up. You can just select the dotted line and put a bend in it and double click the bend point if you want a straight connection, or move the bend point to a desired position. By the way, you can click on this icon to toggle between the upper side of the circuit board, the lower side, or both sides. So in Fritzing, the yellow lines refer to connections on the upper layer, whereas orange lines refer to connections on the under layer. However, we will be using the yellow lines to refer to the wires to be soldered on the perf board, and the orange lines to refer to the jumper wires that connect to the Arduino. The wires to be soldered on the perf board, the yellow lines, will actually be on the underside of the perf board. Here, another positive line extends from the positive pin that is connected to the 4.8 volt battery. Actually, I need to move this wire to the top layer by right-clicking the wire and selecting Move to Top Layer. I should toggle the layer icon to the top layer. This pin corresponds to the signal wire of the right servo, and we'll connect a wire from here to PWM pin number 9. You can easily put a bend in the wire by left-clicking and dragging the newly made bending point of the wire to a desired position. Although we will not be getting a PCB manufactured, it is worth noting that it is best to avoid sharp 90-degree corners in the circuit, as it may cause problems in the manufacturing process. In our case, we'll be using wires which don't have 90-degree bends in them anyway. Next, we'll connect another positive wire from the VCC pin for the ultrasonic sensor to the positive pin to which the positive wire of the SG90 servo connects. I'll just move the SG90 servo connector pins up a bit more. Then we connect the positive pin for the SG90 servo to the positive pin for the left servo. As you can see, the ground pin for the ultrasonic sensor is also tentatively connected to the ground pin of the ICSP connector pins, which is not what we want. Well, if we first connect a wire from the ground pin for the left servo to ground on the Arduino, the suggested connection between the ground pin for the ultrasonic sensor and the ground pin of the ICSP still remains. However, connecting the ground of the left servo to the ground of the SG90 seems to fix this issue. Now let's connect a wire from the ground pin for the ultrasonic sensor to the ground pin for the SG90 servo. Now let's connect the ground pin for the right servo to the ground on the Arduino, and also the ground pin to which the battery holder is connected to another ground on the Arduino. I'm not sure why the suggested connection is shown here at the other ICSP on the Arduino, but we'll just have to ignore that for now. Toggle to the bottom layer, which isn't actually going to be the bottom layer on our perf board in practice, and create a connection from the echo pin of the ultrasonic sensor to the digital pin number 7, and likewise connect the trig pin of the ultrasonic sensor to digital pin number 4. Next, we should connect the pin for the signal wire of the left servo to PWM pin number 10. Don't worry so much about the wires crossing each other at this stage, we'll sort that out in a moment. Now we don't know why there's a suggested connection between these two terminals, so let's check the terminal here. And it's actually the ground pin, so we have the pins for the SG90 around the wrong way. That's easily fixed by rotating the SG90 by 180 degrees, but we also need to move the connections. So, toggle to the top layer, and we need to delete the two wires that we thought, or at least I thought, were connected to the ground. As you can see, the ground from the ultrasonic sensor, the HCSR04, was actually connected to the pin for the signal wire. Now we can ignore the suggested connection line and instead connect the ground pin for the ultrasonic sensor to the ground pin for the SG90. Then connect that ground pin to the ground pin for the left servo. Actually, it looks like there is a wire connected between the signal pin and the ground pin here, and it doesn't look as though we can convince it to just extend from the signal pin only, so we'll delete that, and automatically a newly suggested connection from the signal pin of the SG90 to the PW pin number 11 of the Arduino appears, which is what we want. So let's make that connection. Also, that strange suggested connection between the two pins of the ICSP on the Arduino has disappeared, so it looks as though Fritzing is happy with our basic connections. Go back to the breadboard and you can see that all our basic connections are essentially the same. For example, trig from the HCSRO4 is connected to the digital pin number 4 on the Arduino, and echo is connected to the digital pin number 7, just like our PCB layout, which is in fact our perfboard layout. I see I have the label for the SG90 upside down, so I'll just fix that. To do that, you first left click the rectangle and then you right click the label and click flip rotate on the pull down menu and rotate the label. Now in Fritzing, as I mentioned before, the yellow wires are connections on the top layer and the orange lines are connections on the bottom layer. However, in our case, since we will not be ordering a PCB to be manufactured, we can make our own rules. Namely, the yellow lines will be the wires that we will be soldering, whereas the orange lines represent jumper wires that are to be connected to the Arduino. It is best to avoid the yellow lines from crossing each other, because that may make it harder to solder the wires. So we are going to need to change the color of some of these wires. First, the wire that goes from the signal pin for the right servo and extends to the PWM pin number 9 needs to be orange. So to do that, we just select the wire and select to move to bottom layer. And we will do the same to all the wires that extend externally to the Arduino. So these two ground wires here and this other wire that goes to the ground of the other side of the Arduino will also need to be changed. Now toggle the layer to the top layer so that the yellow lines can be seen better. So these yellow lines are actually the wires that will need to be soldered to the underside of the header pins at the locations shown, except they will be on the lower layer. So a total of 6 short wires. Okay, now it's time to transfer this design onto an actual perf board design. We will do this by creating a new sketch. We will not need this breadboard, so we can delete it. Now search in the parts bin for perfboard, and we have 2 perfboards here. I'm not sure what the difference is between the two, so just drag one of them onto the canvas. Enter the number of columns and rows your perfboard has. Mine has 28 columns and 18 rows, so I'll do that, and press set board size. Now we need to add some header pins to our perfboard, so search generic male header pin, and we get the type of header pins we want. There's a 3-pin one, a 4-pin one, and a 2-pin, but you can adjust that to any number of pins. So let's first grab a 4-pin type. Let's just switch back to the other sketch, and you can see that we want 4 header pins here for the HCSRO4. So let's go back and let's rotate that and move it here at the center with respect to the width direction. Now we need a row of 3 pins for the SG90 micro servo. Let's rotate it and place it so that the wires from these pins will not interfere with the wires that will extend from the HCSRO4. Next, a set of 2 pins for the power source. As you can see, when I switch back to the drawing of the other sketch, we have the power source, the VCC, located here. And then a set of 3 pins for the right servo, and we can duplicate that for the left servo. Please note, the left side of this design is the front side of the robot, but the left and right servos are reversed because we are viewing from the underside. Now it's time to connect the positive wires. So let's switch back to the other sketch, and we can see that a positive wire goes from the power source to the middle pin of the right servo. Another positive wire goes from the power source to the VCC of the HCSRO4, and then from there the positive wire extends to the positive pin for the SG90. So let's just quickly go back and put in those wires. You don't need to search for a wire to do this, by the way. Move the wire out of the way of the other pins and then color it red. Next, connect another red positive wire between the power source and the VCC pin on the HCSRO4 and another positive wire from there to the middle pin for the SG90. I'll just add a few bends to keep this wire away from the other pins. Let's switch back to the other design, and we can see that there is one last positive wire between the middle pins of the SG90 and the left servo. So let's flip back and add the last red wire. Now it's time to add the ground wires, so we'll take another look at the other design, and we can see that there are only two ground wires that we need to worry about, so we'll put those in now while colouring them black. Now let's take a look at the orange coloured connections on the other design. Although these connections to the Arduino are correct, in practice we will either need to solder one end of each wire to each connection point on the perf board and use a male jumper terminal or pin at the other end to be connected to the Arduino, or we will need to use jumper wires with the female end connected to a header pin on the perf board. So I think it will be more convenient just to use jumper wires for these connections rather than soldering them. However, a single header pin on the perf board cannot receive two female headers, so we will need to provide an additional header pin on the perf board for each wire that connects with the Arduino. Let's go back to our perf board and search for generic male header pin. And we need to choose one of these, drag it onto the canvas, and change the number of pins to 1. We are going to place it here, which is behind the trig pin of the HCSR04. As you can see in the other diagram, we have a wire going from there to digital pin number 4 of the Arduino. So we'll flip back and drag a wire from this new pin to an external position here. Color it green and make a few bends. Or actually, we'll move it over to this side and bend it like this, so that the wire will run along the length direction outside the perf board. Also, we will need to connect the new pin to the trig pin, which in practice will be connected by using solder rather than a small wire like this. We also have a wire extending from the echo pin of the HCSR04 to the digital pin number 7. So we will do the same for the echo pin too, but colour the wire blue. We also have two ground wires extending from these two ground pins, so let's duplicate another pin and place it beside the ground here, and another pin here. Then, like with the other external wires, extend a wire from each of these newly placed pins to an external position. These two external positions correspond to two ground pins on the Arduino. Jumping back to the other design, we have a signal wire from the right servo to the PWM pin number 9 on the Arduino. So we'll do that wire next by duplicating another pin and extending a wire to the external position here. Do the same for the signal wire from the left servo to the PWM pin number 10 on the Arduino, and also for the signal wire from the SG90 to the PWM pin number 11 on the Arduino. Lastly, we will extend a wire from the ground pin of the left servo via a newly added pin also. I also need to add a connection between the pin for the signal wire of the SG90 and the newly added pin next to it. It is important to indicate a connection between these newly added single pins, otherwise the connection is broken at that point. And then we have our circuit design ready for the next stage, and that is to physically solder the header pins onto the perf board, and also physically solder the internal red and black wires. After doing that, we can test our circuit out. If the link for part 3 is not shown here, I might not have uploaded part 3 yet. If that's the case, check the description for further details on my latest uploading schedule. Thank you so much for watching.